Their bodies were found in the swamp, actually behind their home, so the killer did not think to go very far away. And family members had not heard or seen from either of the Kleins in several weeks. And the last time Raymond had been seen at his regular work of scrapping metal was February 21st. So on the night of March 7th, Todd Michael Jackson, 34 years old, was taken into custody near his home in Lakeland, Florida, on two counts of first-degree murder. An official said that Todd Jackson shot the two victims in the head as they were sleeping at the crime scene. And Sheriff Grady Judd described Todd as a cold-blooded murderer and said that he had access to the couple's home because they were already acquaintances. Now, Nerissa, you know this is not uncommon. People usually don't get shot in cold blood by a stranger. So they were already acquainted. And actually, there was a possible motive here because investigators suspected that Todd shot the Kleins because they allegedly owed him about $30,000. So these detectives said that following the shooting, Todd reached out to 19-year-old Larry James Waters Jr. And this young man, he's only 19, was dating his stepdaughter, Amberlynn Nicole. And Amberlynn is 19 also. And actually enlisted them to help get rid of the bodies. I don't understand how somebody does that when, in good conscience, to these young individuals who are obviously not as well equipped to make good decisions.
Right. First of all, I mean, Todd Michael Jackson, he was selfish and callous and hateful and just so cruel to kill the Kleins, allegedly, in their sleep at their home after being there. Acquaintance/friend.
Maybe even
a
friendly.
Friend.
That's right,
you know,
a friend.
He had access to their home. They trusted him. He kills them in their sleep at their home.
Defenseless, right?
Yes.
There's no fair fight here.
Yeah. According to police, you know, Todd Jackson, he's 34 years old. This 19-year-old looks up to him. Mm-hmm. He's dating his, you know, stepdaughter. And he comes to the aid of his, you know, hopeful maybe one day stepdad-in-law, I don't know, whomever he's trying to impress or be loyal to.
I mean, look at these little babies.
They have their whole lives ahead of them.
Yes.
And here comes, you know, Todd with this master plan of concealing the body. So he calls Waters, and allegedly they are supposed to get rid of these bodies from the room of the couple.
Right. So there was no disguising this.
No.
I think he was actually very clear. I killed these people. Now help me get rid of their bodies.
Yes.
They both knew about it. And said that to authorities.
What did we say? Just say no to drugs and just say no when people are bringing you that BS of things that you never want to be involved with. You help me get rid of it. No, you're on your own.
Nope.
No, keeping it 100 here. So many cases people have served time, even life sentences for being involved in someone else's mess and helping them cover it up. So now you have these two 19-year-olds who didn't take the lives of the Kleins, but here comes, you know, Waters to help, you know, Jackson, and they use a furniture, allegedly, you know, he asked Waters to help him move the AC unit that's in the couple's bedroom window, and then push the bodies outside, according to authorities, and then Jackson and Waters use a furniture dolly to transport the couple's bodies to that swampy area in back of their home in this wooded area where their bodies were found 2 weeks later, decomposed. So he has ruined these two. You know, they're basically, and they're 19, but look at them. I mean, it's like
they're babies, really.
They had their whole lives ahead of them. And now Amber Nicole Nichols, you know, she really is where this investigation and this crime started to unravel and things were brought to light, because she was trying to sell Raymond Klein's truck, the husband, his pickup, his truck for $200 to these potential buyers. And she told the buyers that the owner had been killed and that they needed to get rid of the vehicle.
Now,
police say that's when they were brought in, because these potential buyers contacted police. And then that's when they began to investigate, looking for the owner of said truck.
Yes.
No people here, you know, found. They started to continue to investigate. And not only did Nichols lead them straight to the decomposing bodies in the swamp. She led them there, but she and Waters were arrested, and they admitted to knowing about the murder. And then the search began for Jackson, who was later arrested. But on top of that, they also have a witness who told police that they were there at the Klein's home when Jackson shot and murdered the couple and saw him do it.